إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد عبده ورسول الله. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في الكتاب الكريم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. وقال عز وجل يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. وقال عز وجل إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد الفاتح لما أغلق والخاتم لما سبق ناصر الحق بالحق والهادي إلى صراطك المستقيم وعلى آله حق قدره ومقداره العظيم آمين. أما بعد. We begin in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by praising Him, by glorifying Him. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send peace and blessings upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we ask Allah to shower this gathering with His mercy and make it a source of benefit for us in this world and the next. Alhamdulillah, one of the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Qur'an and focuses on in the Qur'an is the honor that He's given to the human beings. He mentions that He has honored the children of Adam. لَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمْ. And in many, many different ayat, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the creation of the human being, or the blessings that are given to the human being, or the signs that have been shown to the human being, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He directly or indirectly alludes to the fact that this is an honored creation of Allah. In Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, He announced to the angels, وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً. He said to the angels, I'm going to create on this earth a khalifa. And our ulama, they said, khalifa is a representative. Khalifa is an ambassador. Someone who represents someone else's interests. And the human being is there to represent Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the earth. So the angels, they start to question. قَالُوا وَتَجْعَلُ فِيهَا مَا يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا وَيَسْفِكُ الدِّمَا. Ya Allah, you're going to create this creation, this human being. They're going to shed blood and cause corruption. What's the reason for this? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنِّي أَعْلَمُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. I know something you don't know. I know something about this human being you don't know. And then He creates Adam alayhi salam, our father, and then He teaches Adam alayhi salam, and then He tests the angels. وَعَلَّمَ آدَمَ أَسْمَاءَ كُلَّهَا. Adam was given the names of all things. And some of the ulama said he was given the names of all the existence, all the created things. Others they say he was given the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Adam alayhi salam not only was able to name everything, but he also knew the names of Allah. And so he had the highest knowledge of Allah of all the creation. And so when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked the angels about the names, they say, La ilma lana illa ma 'allamtana. Glory be to you, we have no knowledge except what you've already programmed in us. إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. But Adam عليه السلام is then told to teach them the names. And Adam عليه السلام teaches them the names. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts this creation. And so, in the creation of the human being, our ulama said there is two layers to this. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the way He has created everything, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created everything in layers. When you zoom in, for example, just in the physical world, you have inside you, at the molecular layers, you know, you have different molecules bumping into each other, moving around, you know, bonding, breaking bonds. But then you zoom out, you see cells. Right? You see proteins, you see these things. You zoom out, you see organs, you know, functioning together. The system, there's veins, there's lungs, there's heart, all of these things working together. And then you zoom out, you see the human being's face. Right? Smiling. So, there's layers in the creation. And everything that you look at, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the way He created it, is impeccable. There's perfect flow in everything. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He directs our attention to the leaves, for example. You look at the leaves on the tree, every one of them has intricate pattern of veins, and every one of them is different. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَفِي أَنفُسِكُمْ, and inside yourself, أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ, don't you see that you all have two eyes, two ears, a face, but no two people look the same, subhanallah. And throughout your life, you're always in a state of transformation, you're always changing form. You may not notice it because it's happening very slowly, but then you look at your picture from 10 years ago, and you're like, I used to look like that? Man, I've changed. Right? And you're constantly changing. And then if you look at, you know, all the billions of people on the earth, all of them have the same feature, but none of them look the same. And even in your hands, there's intricate patterns on your fingertips. No two fingertips are the same. And no two fingerprints of any human being is the same, from beginning of time until the end of time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showing us the grandness of His creation. And then our ulama said that the human being is different than all the other creatures. All the other creatures are created, are commanded into existence. The human being has an aspect of them that is created, and an aspect of them that is commanded. And what does that mean? أَلَا لَهُ الْخَلْقُ وَالْأَمْرُ تَبَارَكَ اللَّهُ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Isn't it His, the creation and the command, and the glory is to Allah, the Lord of the worlds. Our ulama said that there are creation below the arsh and above the arsh. Below the arsh, everything that exists is created, and it happens in chains. One event leads to another, leads to another, leads to another. وَخَلَقَكُمْ أَتْوَارًا, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we created you in stages. And then above that is the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Certain creations of Allah, certain beings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought into existence, there is no process, there is no asbab. Allah just says to them, be, and they are. Kun fayakun. And He mentions about it in the Quran, إِنَّمَا أَمْرُهُ إِذَا أَرَادَ شَيْئًا أَن يَقُولَ لَهُ كُن فَيَكُونَ. If Allah wants something to be, He just says be, and it becomes. Right? And one of the things the people were very curious about is the ruh. They came to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Said, Ya Rasulullah, tell us about the ruh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الرُّوحِ. They ask you about the ruh. قُلُ الرُّوحُ مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي. It's from the command of Allah. It's from the affairs of Allah. وَمَا أُوتِيكُم مِّنْ عِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. And you have not been given knowledge of it except a little. And what is that little knowledge? Our ulama, they said, is that all the created things have a spirit. Everything that has life has a spirit in it. And the spirit of the animals and the spirit of the angels, these are all ruh makhluqa. They're created. But the human being is manfukha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala breathed into Adam alayhi salam the ruh. So Adam alayhi salam's ruh is not created. It's the breath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so our ulama said that when you look at the creation and you look at the world, those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they have been given a very high position. And those who disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they have been made the lowest of the low. And one of the campaigns that's happening now is to turn people into atheists, to deny them, you know, to deny Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one of the ways, interestingly enough, they do this is they say, oh, you think you're special? You sit in this small, tiny planet, in this tiny earth. Compared to the universe, what's the planet? It's nothing. So you're this insignificant creation on this tiny speck of rock floating in this vast universe. How come you think you're special? And sure enough, if you look at it from the perspective of the physical reality, the physical body is nothing. It's an insignificant creation. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, those people who deny the resurrection, ask them, are you harder to create or the heavens and the earth? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the universe and the galaxies and stars and planets, all these things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can create the likes of you, no problem. Right? So when they look at the world and they look at themselves, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows them how small they are. And some of the Quraysh, when the Prophet was inviting them to Allah, they said, you know what, this is too big. We don't want to think about Day of Judgment, answering to Allah, all these things. We have shufa'a for us, people that will come and intercede for us. Right? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is inviting them because, oh human being, you're not created to have barriers between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're an honored creation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you for Himself. Allah created you for Himself.
And so there is no intermediaries between you and your Creator. You come to Allah and you say, Rabbi, my Lord. And Allah will respond to you. Ud'uni, Allah says, astajib lakum. You call upon me, I will respond to you. You ask of me, I'll take care of you. You place your trust in me, I will be enough for you. وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهِ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُ. Right, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, O human being, you are not insignificant. You have Allah. And now, when Adam alayhi salam was created, angels, they had this idea that they are this great creation. They said, نَحْنُ نُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِكَ وَنُقَدِّسُ لَكَ. And they had some claim to greatness. They used to worship Allah day and night. The Prophet ﷺ described to us their worship. From beginning of time until the end of time. Standing, bowing down, making sajda, continuously, no breaks, nothing. They don't sleep, they don't rest, they don't need a bathroom. They are created to worship. So they said, you know, تَجْعَلُ فِيهَا مَا يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا وَيَسْفِكُ الدِّمَاءُ وَنَحْنُ نُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِكَ وَنُقَدِّسُ لَكَ. In other words, Ya Allah, why do you need these human beings to worship you? We are doing that. Why are you honoring this creation? We are the honored ones, worshiping you. And they had a claim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored Adam alayhi salam and he told all the angels to bow down to Adam. Right? So all the angels, despite their acts of worship, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I'm choosing Adam above you. I'm making Adam a creation that I have chosen and you have to serve him. He's above you. So the angels bowed. Iblis had a claim to greatness. He said, أَنَا خَيْرٌ مِّنْ خَلَقْتَنِي مِنْ نَارٍ وَخَلَقْتَهُ مِنْ تِينٍ. I'm better than him. I'm created from fire. He's created from earth. Iblis saw what Adam alayhi salam was created from. He didn't see the essence of the human being. The reality of the human being, which is the breath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now has three creations contending for greatness. Angels show their acts of worship. Iblis shows that, you know, he's a better race of creation. Adam alayhi salam, first thing he shows, he disobeys Allah. Allah tells him, don't eat from this tree. Adam eats from the tree. And after he disobeys Allah, what does he say? رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا وَإِلَّمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُنَّنَا مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Oh Allah, we have wronged ourselves. We are weak. If you don't have mercy on us and forgive us, we will be losers. So our ulama said, the greatness of Adam alayhi salam, this is where it's shown. In his weakness, Allah created Adam weak, human being weak, able to slip and sin and fall into despair and all these other things. Why? So they can keep clinging to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Keep holding on to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what's greater than Allah's mercy? The worship of the angels? The material with which Iblis was made from? The greatest thing is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not a thing. I mean, limitation of language. Allah's mercy has no limits, no bounds. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened that up for all of us. Oh human being, you want heights? You want greatness? Al-A'raf, the heights of the heights? Come to Allah. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to us messengers to give us the same message. Now what happened is as we're living on this earth and we forget where we came from, and our ulama said, human being is in three stages, right? At first, they're a wayfarer, they're a traveler, they're coming to this world. And so you're in the knowledge of Allah. You didn't yet exist, but Allah knows you're going to exist. And then what happens? You enter into the world of existence. And then you enter into the womb. And then you enter into the dunya. So the whole time, you're a wayfarer, you're traveling. And then you enter this world. وَنَبِّعْهُمْ أَنْ ذَيْفِ إِبْرَاهِيمِ. Tell them about the guests of Ibrahim. When you enter this world, you are now a guest. Right? In this dunya, you're a guest. And one of the things about the treatment of guests in our religion, Ibrahim alayhi salam was the best example of that. He was very hospitable. Very hospitable. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you're in this world, even though you're his slave, you're his creation, you're here for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah treats the people as guests. Whether you accept him, you don't accept him. Allah will honor you. Allah will make it comfortable for you. He'll give you a home, he'll give you food, he'll give you water, you'll have clothing. Right? We're not walking around, you know, naked. We are the ones disgracing ourselves. Allah honored the human beings. And so the only thing required of the guest is to have adab, courtesy. When you go to somebody's home and you're a guest, you don't just walk into their bedroom, right? There's etiquettes, there's codes of conduct. So the human being, while they're in this world, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, only thing He wants from us is to have etiquette with Him. Right? And when you're here, you know, you're still a guest, you're not residents here. But when you leave, then you go to your homes. You become your full residents. Where is your home? Either Ahlul Nar, or Ahlul Jannah, or Ahlullah. Right? And so, our ulama said, the human being is traveling through this world. They're guests in this world. And while you're here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent us messengers to remind us this. Oh human being, you're not from here. You're actually visiting here. You're a guest. You're on your way to your home. Where is your home? You gotta choose. Because there's different neighborhoods you can end up in. There's the places of gardens and bliss, and there's places of despair and disasters. Where are you going? And they spoke the truth. But those who lost sight of the fact that they're guests, they start looking at their life. They're comfortable right now. They said, this is going to last forever. You know, if I just had a little bit more money, I would be happy. And they start getting consumed by the dunya. And when somebody comes and tells them the truth, you know what they say? They don't want to hear it. Bani Israel, prime example. When their prophets came to them with messages reminding them, oh people, you're going back to Allah. You know, get your stuff together. You're going back to Allah. And you're going to answer for all these things. Because if you're breaching codes of etiquette, this is your place is not in a good place. And they didn't want to hear the truth, so they start killing their prophets. يَقْتُلُونَ النَّبِيِّينَ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ. They kill their prophets without any justification. Some of the people reading these ayat, they say, oh, they killed their prophets, how horrible people. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ulama ummati ka-anbiya bani Israel. The scholars of my ummah are like the messengers of Bani Israel. And we are attacking our scholars left and right. We are killing our scholars. Our ummah is doing the same thing Bani Israel did to their scholars. Right? Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored us and told us, you are guests, you're going back to Allah. We said, no, we're not guests, we want to stay here. You can't stay here. Your body's changing all the time. You know, one of the signs is aging. People start changing and, you know, things you used to be able to do, you can't do anymore. Allah says, وَمَن نُعَمِّرْهُ نُنَكِّسُ فِي الْخَلْقِ أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. Whoever we let them live for some time, we start reducing them in creation. Don't you use your intellect? Like you're on your way out. You're passing through time. Your time is not standing still. But we have this illusion, right? Because right now, these walls are solid. These things are solid. You look at these giant companies like Google, Amazon, solid companies, right? And so we look at the way they are now and we think, oh yeah, this stuff is going to stay here. But if you put in a camera in front of a tree and take a picture every 30 minutes and then just play the video, what happens? You see it grow, get big, flowers come out, and then the flowers go away, and then the thing starts to wither, and then the wind comes and takes the dust away. And you can do the same thing here. If you fast forward this room, people coming, going, 100 years from now, where are these walls? 200 years from now, right? 1,000 years from now, things turn to rubble. And we're not even going to be around to see it. And that's one of the things that makes people sad, is they look at history now, what's happening now, and they think, what's going to happen? The world is a disaster, all these things. How is this movie going to end? Go to the Quran, Allah will tell you. Everything's been spelled out already. The people that have been doing good, Allah will reward them for their goodness. The people that have been doing evil, they will see what's coming to them. And in the end, every affair belongs to Allah. وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ شَهِدًا. And Allah is enough as a witness. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us. قُلِ خَوْلِ هَذَا صَفْرَ لَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى أما بعد. And so the question becomes, what do you want? What do you want? And this is a very difficult question. Like if you ever, I'm married, sometimes I ask my wife, what do you want? She says, I don't know what I want, but I want something. Right? And we're constantly searching for what we want. And what we want is always changing and always shifting, depending on when, where we are in our life. What's the most important thing to you? If somebody asks, it really depends on what you're going through. If you're hungry and you're dying of hunger, most important to you is food. If you have no shelter, no roof over your head, probably the most important thing on your mind is having a place, you know, to rest. If you have a business problem or these big projects, most important thing to you is that thing that's on your mind. Depending on what's going on, somebody's sick, they're in bed, they can't move. For them, it's their health. Ya Allah, heal me. Right? But all of these things, our scholars said, it changes from moment to moment to moment. A child, for him, it may be a gum. A teenager might want a car. A person getting married might want a big wedding. A person who's married might want a bigger house or a promotion or whatever. Somebody who's elderly might want to be able to just walk on their own feet. You know, all of that stuff that's on the surface layer, it's always changing. But underneath it all of these things that we want stems from one reality. They all come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And our ulama said, whoever wants Allah above and beyond everything else, Allah will give them the dunya, Allah will give them the akhirah, and on the day of judgment, they will have the honor of seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, the Prophet ﷺ told us, you know, when you give liwajhillah, for the face of Allah. What does that mean? In Surah Al-Insan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about people who spend, innama nut'imukum liwajhillah. We are only feeding you for the face of Allah. We don't ask you for any reward for this. So our ulama said, you know, these are different stations of people. There are some people who do things because they want dunya. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَا يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنًا وَمَا لَهُمْ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنْ خَلَاقٍ. There are some people, they go to Hajj. They're making tawaf around the Kaaba. And their entire concern is, Ya Allah, make my business successful. Ya Allah, make my children, pass their school. Give them good jobs. Give them this. Get them married. This is all their concerns. Dunya, dunya, dunya. Allah says, because they have no concern for akhirah, they only get the dunya, but they don't get the akhirah. And then there are others who say, Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana, wa fi al-akhirati hasana. Oh Allah, give us good in this world, and good in the next. And save us from the hellfire. So the people that ask for the akhirah, there's two types. They ask for dunya and akhirah. And the ones that ask for akhirah, one of them is worshipping Allah because they're afraid of the hellfire. Another one's worshipping Allah because they really are enticed by Jannah. Did you say Hur al-Ain? MashaAllah, I really want that, right? So they'll start doing more acts of worship, the Hajj prayers. You know, why? Because they want to drink wine in Jannah. No problem. Alhamdulillah, it's halal. Right? Work for it. You know, drinks of Jannah, Allah describes them in crystal cups, salsabila and kafura. So, alhamdulillah, this is an enticement. But then there is a layer above that, a daraja above that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they don't ask for hell, you know, protection from hellfire, they don't ask for Jannah, they don't ask for dunya, they say liwajhillah, only for Allah. Right? And these people, they get the best of the best. As-sabiqoon, as-sabiqoon. May Allah make us of them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those who are honored by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who are elevated by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who's in the presence of Allah in this world and the next. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us an example and the embodiment of the teachings of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enrich us with the character of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to love us like he loved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Rabbil Alameen, we ask you, anyone going through hardship, Ya Allah, grant us ease, Ya Allah. Anyone going through difficulties in their health, grant us shifa, Ya Allah. Anyone struggling in their financial affairs, provide for us halal and tayyib rizq, Ya Allah. Ya Rabbil Alameen, all of our families, Ya Rabbil Alameen, protect us from the fitan of this world, Ya Allah. Ya Arhamar Rahmeen, make us people of truth, Ya Allah, and make us supporters of the truth with the truth, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim, we ask you, anyone going through any kind of struggles in their deen, Ya Allah, we ask you to clear the confusion from our hearts, Ya Allah, and grant us steadfastness upon your deen, Ya Allah, and don't let our hearts deviate after you guided us, Ya Allah. Ya Rabbil Alameen, we ask you on the day of judgment, allow us to stand hand in hand with your prophets, with the awliya, with the siddiqeen, Ya Allah, and grant us shade under the throne, Ya Allah, amongst those who loved one another for your sake, Ya Allah, and enter us into Jannatul Firdausul A'la, Ya Allah, the highest levels of Jannah, Ya Allah, and protect us and all of our loved ones from the hellfire, Ya Allah. Ya Rabbil Alameen, we ask you to grant us
the rizq of being able to look upon your countenance, ya Allah. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Aqimu salam.